Then the section, we have the sections are called, there's, for example, here, national. We have, is about affirmation. There is advertising, for example, here. These are the sections, the business section, and there is international, and more other things. Then you have headline. Here, this is our headline. This is our headline. The drop head. The drop head might be like, sometimes you see the headline, there's maybe a small headline again, or maybe it might be, for example, like this one, it might be a drop head. After the head, then the drop. Okay? Now we have also what is called byline. A byline is a section that contains the name of the reporter. So here it's like by Taonga Sabora. Who is the one? The reporter. Okay, then you have byline, it's where we need to get the name of who wrote the that article, sometimes it is the city. Okay?
Yes.
Then you have deadline. Deadline is about, it's actually like yes, Monday, August 7, 2023. Okay? Then you have the lead. The lead is the first paragraph of what? The article. And then now we have the body, like the whole kind of this one. But also, there is adjective now. Here, the date is considered. My last one would be championship now. So, when I was actually thinking about this, I didn't bother to say to me that because I thought some of this dialect. Dialect things like why we need layout. So we have actually defined what is the layout and the elements that you think when you want to place this one should be here, where to place this one. Consider that. Now, why do we need to learn, or maybe rather it's layout? Why is the layout important? So, the first one is to ensure a smooth flow of weight, material, and information through a system. So, a system might be like part XP or InDesign 1.1. So, you have that one, a system that you use to what? So, when you have a layout, you just the way it becomes easy. Because you just say, okay, this one paste here, this one paste here. But if you don't have a layout, every day you have to wake up, how should we lay out this one? If you look the layout of that front page and this one, it's just the same. That's just about editing the information and putting pasting in the whatever. So that's the advantage of what? The layout. The second one, and no one can actually deny. The layout is there to attract leadership. Readership. So people should read the newspaper because of how it has been laid out. So, for example, if you want to form a newspaper for the university, and maybe you have interest, okay, Mr. Jackson, you do a layout, and then you have to think, is my layout is more attractive to the audience or to the to the reader? Are they going to be reading this? So, need also to think about that. And it also optimizes the newspaper's effectiveness in presenting information. Optimizes to give it value, give it face like value. So the newspaper effectiveness in presenting information. So they are the page full, please put something that will attract people. The second page, put something that concerns people. The third page, put something about business or something about us. The other one, put about advertising. Now people should see what they should buy. Now put about sports or about entertainment or international. People should learn about, should know what is happening outside. Oh, if it is advertising, if it is advertising, because this is where we get our money. Like that. Oh, this one has more advertising than that. And then, let's talk about opinion. Oh, opinion and advertising. Sports. What does that mean in sports? And, sports should be there to life, so that people can enjoy that, they should be relaxed with it. If you put sports at face, you are not making your advertising messages effective. Because people after reading the hot news, the current news, political news, then they say, you're talking about sports, you don't need sports. Okay? So that is the sample. Before you okay, I'm going to continue. Okay, so I tried that email the last time I talked about the history of broadcasting industry, like how it began, then we talked about broadcasting as what? Industry. Yeah, so today we just move at you have money to work with it.
Nashambulia intipi, mendo mwenye. Una wa kabo kutoani.
Yeah, so let's start with the first question and the introduction. How have they defined equilibrium and equilibrium or equilibrium? This is a need where you have identified and accepted the equation. You have determined.
But these are materials for the studio for production locally.
Mm-hmm.
That is the furniture to detail the building.
Mm-hmm. So, when you are talking about the equipment, we are simply saying what we have actually defined for the passage. It's anything that we use in the studio that helps us to come up with a program or to produce a program. Even if it's a letter like this one, it might be an agreement if it is a function in some important way, but we are not a mob that a doorman is also an agreement in this history. And then, if it is being used to maybe drop something, or but not as an important stable here when you are entering the studio, then this is an agreement, someone say, oh, wait, that is not true. Yeah, so they have mentioned some of these agreements. Okay, so what are these agreements?
Camera, script, console, microphone.
Signal processing equipment. Okay, so before we actually discuss some of the functions of this basic equipment, maybe we can also look at the definition of studio. We'll go to the main content. Critical definition of room. They have actually defined what a studio is. So we said this equipment things that we use to come up with a program, and then we have mentioned some of these basic equipment like a camera, console, microphone, and recorder. So these things are not found in a tree. You can find them on the roof or maybe on a bench. They are in a certain tin room, a very confiscated, very small room. And this room houses all these materials. And some people say, what should we call this room that is housing all these important equipment? And some of them, can we name it as a studio? Oh, a studio. Okay, then we call it a studio. We have a radio studio and a TV studio. They might have all these equipment, but maybe the way they are functioning, maybe it's a little bit different. So, for example, when we are talking about a recorder in TV studio, it performs the same, let's talk about microphone. It functions the similar activity it is supposed to function, but in this way, it's a little bit about it is hidden, or sometimes you can see it, but in a very special way. In radio, there is much flexibility. You can put it even here, because nobody is looking at you. But in TV, in a very deep way, okay, it's putting flat. That's why we have a TV studio and a radio studio. And there are also mega studios like that people use in Hollywood to produce these vast, you know, these extravagant movies. You know, there's the equipment there and the studio there is actually different from these mini studios that we use to produce combat content. So that is the studio. By definition, women are all the most materials installed in the studio for the production of programs, starting from furniture to digital equipment, as you say. The equipment needed for program production in the broadcast industry include the camera, as you say, the tapes, audio visual players, and the other things that you say. But I'm very keen to learn that if any of this is absent, then production may not take place because one of the equipment would be needed at one stage of production or another. It's true. If you are doing a TV program and you have your camera, but if you don't have a microphone, of course you can come with it, but then the quality of that one, it will fail. Probably, you know, when you are trying to capture voices in the camera microphone, sometimes it's not that really great. Yeah, so we are also trying we have the microphone in that studio, I think, sorry. But it's a studio, I think. Do you know, we did that one, that people who say, what do you do? But basically, but the camera will cut this, this high, so that people should feel like you're just putting on the video camera. Anyway, I think those are very important. And then he said, I can do a TV program without a video video camera. Okay, you have a microphone, please do it. Yeah, so we have also computers which are generally important as part of materials using. And actually, computers, it's very basic. There's some which are basic, but computers is very basic. Okay. So, in simple ways, we have noticed that all these materials have different functions. So, for example, camera. Even if you ask a little child trying to ask that little child, oh, my friend, do you know what is the use of a camera? She said, yes. What is it? Capture video. Ah, okay. So here they said the camera is one of the most important equipment, especially for broadcast program production, without which production cannot work. Popularly known as the video camera, they range from lightweight, handheld visuals to rack heavy duty units. Some are more automatic than others, while earlier cameras were built as completely integrated units. So, television or video camera are of varying types, and their difference is essentially related to the type of pickup tube used. However, the camera in two broad categories, namely monochrome or black and white in color. So, monochrome or black and white in color. So, you have two types of camera, the black and white and the color. So, the black and white, no matter where you are, no matter what effect you have, but it's used just to capture, you know, this kind of black and white color. So, for example, in Hollywood, you find like there's we feel sometimes like maybe they have applied an effect, but they have just used a certain kind of camera. You know, like they show some file or footage where maybe like people, like it's a past or an ancient story, and they say, yeah, they just simply put an effect that they are using, but black and white. And then there's the color, now the fashionable one, the HD 4K Yeah, sometimes they can also integrate the two terminals into one terminal. So you can switch black and white, and you can switch to color one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the general function of the camera is to capture videos. Yeah, so no matter what kind of views, by this function is to do that. They also say we have lighting equipment. These are very dangerous ones. What do you want? Lighting. So what to do, what is called an interview if we have a chance in this room. If it's a TV production, it will be, people will be wondering, these guys are not seeing. Can't even see the person. No matter if that person is white or what. But yeah, the light is not that clear. So people use, they said, okay, I'm going to use now light. Okay, let's use the light. So the light. So the light says, oh, this is the category of lighting. There's bed lighting. This general studio lighting is the use of few light. Then we have model lighting. This lighting is usually directed towards a specific scene or performance. Effect lighting, the amount of light can be varied depending on the production requirement.
So my effect lighting in Europe, I'm really they use like my disco light has a very similar kind of thing.
Yeah, so the main purpose of lighting is to enable the camera to see and take clear pictures and to provide a view of important visual information about an event such as space area, time of day, and even the mood of an event.
Like here, we can want to make it as you see when using lighting. Nanga, people they do something for the jambo and the money you can see. I remember when I was at the temple in Masana. My friend is a nurse. My friend is grown up there. Ah, he has a lot of things that he do. So now I have to know him, but it's just about he and his family just to watch that. So suddenly, like, one of us.
So the microphone is an important equipment needed by broadcasters in the discharge of their duties. Microphone have several types, but they perform one function, that of magnifying the voice of the artist as far as program production is concerned. So no matter what kind of microphone you are using, that is function one, to magnify the voice. The video camera can capture the voice, but it cannot magnify. So you need a microphone. That should magnify. So no matter what, anyway, we have five kinds of microphones. You have omnidirectional microphone. This type of microphone usually has a long cable which can be extended over a considerable space within a given area. It can easily be used for outside broadcast. So these are the kind of microphones that you can, you know, screw the what? This wire, you know, or in somewhere. Like the Adidas, or the Mainanio, 10 kinds of microphones. And directional microphone. This type of microphone can be used in one direction. It can only handle about two persons and not more than that individuals must be positioned in the same direction. So in my, you can see here, someone who sits here, that those in studio, most of them that direction. So you see, here they are, here, huh? See that, eh? Then there is a bi-directional microphone. This kind of microphone can be directed at the voices from different directions at the same time. This type is most suitable for interviews and group discussion situations. So if you just put it, you are eating lunch or enjoying something, and then after that you discuss about something, then you put your microphone here. And then you are sitting here, someone is sitting here, round table discussion. So when you're speaking, people are able to hear what you're speaking. Someone is speaking beside someone, beside someone, beside. Everyone is there, able to be captured. That is it. What is called by, so many by. Personal microphone, I guess. This is the small electric clip on the microphone, which is extensively used for speech pickup. It can be attached to the rapid shade or tie and may be hidden beneath the coffin. So you wonder, like, this person is just speaking, but we can hear him now, you know. Oh, the guest of honor. Hanging or slide microphone. This type of microphone is usually suspended over the actual area and is effective for area sound pickup such as choir and orchestra.
Yes, right. So, have you ever seen a cipher music? Cipher. They hang the microphone like this. People in a song with Zara, they have all right hanging like microphones.
So let's finish with a consumer. According to EDAY 2008, the console is the link between the microphone and the recording channels.
So, a console, like, it's best to be demonstrated with a visual artwork. So, what was? And then, a microphone, so they can go maybe, you can have two microphones. So after collecting the sound, it goes to the console where you think of all, goes to the mixer and it will be mixed.
So it is equipped with standard equalizers, various buttons and switches which are used to regulate and modulate signals. The mixing console has a lot of input and output, which are these days digital overrated. With the introduction of modern technology, the console is still a primary piece of equipment in most production facilities. The broadcast also used in most stations are fair and straightforward in their construction and operation, although the board of the console may appear intimidating because of the numerous buttons.
So a console, but that's one of the studio which is pretty cool, which is my pattern and benefit is my phone. That was the studio console. Yeah, so we discussed it in an introduction to broadcasting. It's a special segment about it. So reaching here, we might say we have done something. So, you can just read in advance, principles and parameters of broadcasting. Just after that, there is that one. Yeah, so, especially, you can also maybe search about what is objectivity, validity, balance, and fairness. Yeah, so, you can read about that so that tomorrow, we can discuss about that. So, yeah. Okay. Or if you have time, you can also read about quality of good broadcasting or broadcaster. Tomorrow we can touch about it. And then, go back to communication graphics a little bit, and video and everything. Broadcasting. Let me get the agenda sheet that you sign.
Thank you.